Tommy Vercetti? Shit.
Didn't they never let him out?
He kept his head down. Helps people forget.
People will remember soon enough. When they see him walking down the streets of their neighborhoods, it will be bad for business.
Well, what are we gonna do, Sonny?
We treat him like an old friend and keep him busy out of town, okay? We've been talking about expanding down south, right? Vice City is 24 karat gold these days. The Colombians, the Mexicans, hell, even those Cuban refugees are cutting themselves a piece of some nice action.
But it's all drugs, Sonny. None of the families will touch that shit.
Times are changing. The families can't keep their backs turned while our enemies reap the rewards. So, we send someone down to do the dirty work for us and cut ourselves a nice, quiet slice, okay? Who's our contact down there?
Kem Rosenberg, schmuck of a lawyer. How's he gonna hold Vercetti's leash?
We don't need him to. We just set him loose in Vice City. We give him a little cash to get started, okay? Give it a few months. Then we go down. Pay him a little visit, right? See how he's doing.
Ken Rosenberg here. Hey! Hey, great, hey. Well, I'm gonna drive you guys to the meet, okay? Now, I've talked to the suppliers, and they are very keen to start a business relationship. So, if all goes well, we should be doing very nicely for ourselves, which is, you know, good. Okay, so, they're brothers, okay? One operates the business, and the other one does the... Okay, that's them in the chopper. All right, here's the deal. They want a straight exchange on open ground. All right? Okay, stay tight. Let's go.
Got it?
100% pure grade A Colombian, my friend.
Let me see it.
The greens?
10s and 20s. Used.
I think we have a deal, my friend.
Oh, shit!
I poke my head out of the gutter for one freaking second and fate shovels shit in my face. Go get some sleep. What are you gonna do?
I'll drop by your office tomorrow and we can start sorting this mess out.
Welcome to Vice City. We will be spending the next few weeks, maybe months, we are going to be doing a 100% playthrough, because of that, we just have a lot of random shit that just becomes available for us to do, and, because most things are available to us whenever, there won't be much of a structure, and I'm fairly sure, I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to be structuring this. So, you never know if, an episode's gonna be based on missions, or an episode is basically gonna be doing, things for 100%. I think right now I will have a list of things we will cover for 100%, unlike other GTA games, most notably San Andreas, there's not a lot of totally optional things from what I'm aware of, that is.
Hello, Sonny.
Tommy! Tommy, it's been too long. I know. You're just overwhelmed with emotion. 15 years.
Seems like only yesterday.
I guess that's a perspective thing.
Hey, doing time for the family is no piece of cake, but the family looks after its own, okay? So how'd the deal go down? You sitting on some white gold?
Look, Sonny, we were set up. The deal was an ambush. Harry and Lee are dead.
You better be kidding me, Tommy! Tell me you still got the money!
No, Sonny. I don't have the money.
That was my money, Tommy! My money! You better not be screwing me, Tommy, because you know I'm not a man to be screwed with!
Wait, Sonny.
You have my personal assurance that I'm gonna get you your money back, and the drugs, and I'm gonna mail you the dicks of those responsible.
Hey, I already know that. You're not a fool, Tommy, but I warn you, neither am I. If it was anybody else, you'd be dead already. But because it's you, because we got history, I'm gonna let you handle this.
Look, Sonny, you got my word.
I'll be in touch.
You know, watching that while listening to an anime opening just seems really fucking weird. But for the cutscene in the game, or cutscenes in this game, I will watch them for the first time and I'll stay quiet during them, but if I fail a mission and I feel like showing the entire attempt again, I will skip the cutscene the second time of any repeat viewings. And another thing I want to touch on before we get started in the meat, or some of the main meat, which I'm not entirely sure if, or like what I want to do, there's 100 of these money bags. They don't look like money bags. Hidden packages rather. I'm not sure how I'll go about collecting them. I'm kind of thinking that if I see them, I will collect any I see. And then if I feel like I might want to collect some more, I will go do that. But at the moment, there's only one amount I want to collect at the moment. You get a reward for every 10 you collect. Be wary of that. Although I think maybe, I don't know, like maybe every fourth episode I might like go out of my way to collect 10 of them. Actually right now I'm just driving up to a location of one that I know. So collecting 60 of these, we are given a minigun, and I want to have that minigun for something that we will eventually cover. Not totally sure when I want to cover it, but the reward of the thing I want to cover is going to be extremely handy. Our health is kind of low at the moment. Sort of thing, and the more health we have, the better. And I guess that kind of that reward kind of does count as health somewhat. I did collect a few monies, so I will pay for it. Although why did I pay for it when there was a good taxi, not taxi, good ambulance right there. So I think I'll aim for the standard 27 minutes, but like, if it's like at 20 minutes, I'm not entirely sure what I want to do, I will just cut there, sort of thing. Okay. I don't know this game at like the back of my hand, but like there are a few things I do know. I won't bother with killing the police, so I'll just go into this mission.
Go get some sleep, he says. I have been sitting in this chair all night with the lights off, drinking coffee. This is a disaster. We are so screwed, man. These gorillas, listen to me, are gonna come down here and rip my head off. It's ridiculous. I did not go to law school for this. Okay, now what the hell are we gonna do?
Shut up, sit down, relax. I'll tell you what we're gonna do. You're gonna find out who took our cocaine. and then I'm gonna kill them.
That's a good idea. That's a great idea. Let me think. Oh, there's this retired colonel, Colonel Juan Garcia Cortez. He's the one that helped me set up this deal well away from Vice City's established thugs, okay? Now listen, he's holding his party out in the bay on his expensive yacht, and all of Vice City's big players are gonna be there, okay? I have an invite. Of course I have an invite. But there's no way that I'm going out there sticking my head out the door. No way,
not gonna happen. I told you, shut up. I'll go myself.
Oh, whoa. Hey, I like 1978 too, but you know, this isn't gonna be a beer and strippers do. I mean, no offense, but I think that you might turn heads on the runway for the wrong reasons.
What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
Okay, look, here, stop by Raphael's. Tell him I sent you. He'll make you look respectable. Okay, go, come on.
What does that guy think he is? Now I gotta dress like a chump as well as hang out with him? I like this shirt.
Not sure, but I feel like, Tommy is much more, talkative than CJ. Because I don't think they did, in between cutscene, like, cutscene and, like, normal gameplay sort of dialogue there with CJ. Although I think they did it, like, somewhat, Anyway, there's probably one big difference I should probably talk about before it happens, I suppose. So if you didn't know, this is not much of a cutscene, CJ was actually the first protagonist to be able to swim in these games, so, we have to be careful around water, since, you wouldn't think it, but water is essentially like a death pit for us right now. I guess not right now, since we do get access to boats later down the line. I'll take the bike. I'm not sure exactly how it's like in Vice City, but I know that in San Andreas that, bikes are like the vehicles to go to, sort of thing. I know a few locations of collectibles, so again, I'll go to them when I can think of any. So do we need to have the radio on for the announcement to appear, or is it like the sort of thing where it's like not right away sort of thing? Because I know that there is an announcement that kind of that explains why we can't go island hopping right now. Do I want to play it risky and do some stunt jumps around it? Although, can we do those stunt jumps? I am playing this on mouse and keyboard, and because I do have, okay, we can't go there quite yet. Yeah, because I am using mouse and keyboard, I do have the keyboard underneath a cover, so don't exactly know where my buttons are.
Buenas noches! I understand you are here on the behalf of Mr. Rosenberg. I hope any recent problems have not affected his health or mental well-being, Mr.
Persetti. He's just got a touch of agoraphobia.
Excellent, excellent. And you?
I just want my merchandise.
Ah, it's an unfortunate set of circumstances for all involved. Of course, I have initiated my own lines of inquiry, but such a delicate matter will take time. Perhaps we'll talk later. Meanwhile, let me introduce you to my daughter. Mercedes! Cara mia, could you look after our guest while I attend to my necessary obligations?
Of course, Daddy.
Please, excuse me.
Mercedes?
You try living with him. Anyway, let me point out some of our more distinguished guests. That's our Congressman Alex Shrub with rising silicone star, Candy Sucks.
And have you met my lovely wife, Laura? No? Well, unfortunately, she's in Alabama. This is Candy.
And over there, we have the Vice City Mamba's star titan, BJ. Always the charmer.
I blacked down on him, and then I put him in a wheelchair.
That is good. Well, now, I'm looking at some prime
rib. And that poolside amphibian is Jez Torrent, lead singer with Love Fist.
Can I tell you, do you know how they play ping pong in Thailand? Let me tell you, it does not involve a paddle, if you know what I
mean. Impotent. And the chatty trio, that sleeping sweat gland is Papa's right-hand gimp, Gonzalez. And the other two are Pastor Richards and pseudo-intellectual film director Steve Scott.
Fishing throws a passion with the nipple invaders when the giant shark comes in and just bites their dicks off. I know, you never saw anything like that before.
Colonel, your party's as ever a triumph. I can only apologize.
Well, then another amigo. How do we find you?
Our business is very trying. Barbarians at the gate. A time for rewarding one's friends and liquidating one's enemies, amigo.
Who's the loudmouth?
Ricardo Diaz. He's Mr. Cope.
Mercedes!
Oh, I was just taking my friend back into town. Another time, Ricardo.
Ricardo, let's go.
Let's get out of here. Sure. Actually, take me to the proposition.
Drinks.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's just my version, but, these subtitles don't sync up quite that right.
Will you be working for my father?
Maybe. Not sure if I want to talk over these, but I don't know. Maybe. I might just talk whenever, like just let it play out whenever I can't think of anything to say. Yeah. I should forget if this is the entire mission. It might be. Okay, yeah, some of the initial missions are kind of on the short end. And yeah, because we do have a bit more money than they kind of expected us to because of the hidden packages. Also, yes, unlike GTA, San Andreas, or I guess later games, we don't entirely have, or we don't have complete customization. But we do have some outfits to change between. So if it seems like I'm comparing this game a lot to San Andreas. It's the only other GTA game I have total experience with, so that might be why. Also, I guess because it might be the first episode topic, but this is at the moment my favorite GTA game. Only because it's kind of stylized. I feel like after San Andreas they kind of stopped stylizing the games. Kind of made them more realistic. And speaking about... Oh, okay, fuck you. I should mention that a few cars can let you... a few things like armor, upgrades, like weapons sort of thing, so... It might be in your best interest to just randomly hop in a car and then hop back out to get a few things. Already halfway to 10. I think there might be a 6th one around here somewhere. Either a 6th one or a rampage. Okay, yeah, there's number 6. Do I know where 5 more are exactly? I'm not sure, but I think I might do a rampage right now. Back up a little bit and kill them. For the rampages and only the rampages are you given infinite ammo. Although, oddly enough, you don't pick up money or weapons. I mean, the weapons part I can kind of understand, because like, they don't really want you to switch out weapons, but like... Why can't we pick up money? Exactly. And a handy thing to note when doing rampages is that if you come in with a wanted level, if you do it successfully, and I do mean successfully, you lose your wanted level completely. So I'm not sure, depending on how fucked I end up getting, I might just go do a rampage, depending on what it is. Also, our movement isn't completely fluid, which is kind of weird considering that, like, at the time Super Mario Sunshine was out. Why did I throw a grenade? Yeah, let's go rob a place, why not? Let's go knock off one of the 15 that we need to do. Oh, no. Right. What? Buttons? Okay, there we go. I mean, I suppose we could have robbed him earlier, but, you know, or, like, in a better way, but, you know, okay, yeah, jump is space, we have access to the, pain spray at the moment, don't we? Was that a thing that's locked until later? Hopefully it isn't. I think in later games it is. Maybe. Hopefully I don't get arrested. Because that would be a bad way to end off the first episode. Wouldn't you think? Although we did get, like, a few things done. Although not the few things that you'd think we would be doing. This might be a cheap way to lose our wanted level, but, if you save and reload, you do, lose it. Do I just want to run the way back? Or do I pick up what the rampage is? And also, another thing that might be a little bit different from what you might think is that, there's somewhat a cover feature in the jump button, so, if we get too close to cars, it's not really the best idea to jump, since you might just, end up jumping into a car. So, you know. From what I know, parked cars are fine to jump on, so let's save, I'll grab that one. Yep, and then quickly start new game, load game, and there you go. Wanted level erased. Yeah, I should mention this is like one of the final things we do. I won't be loading a new game every time we fail a mission. If we fail or I die. I will just let it happen, sort of thing, because I kind of feel like that's kind of cheap of a thing to do, especially since money is pretty much plentiful in this game, from what I remember. So, you know, I feel like we've done enough for this episode, so. In this episode, we came to Vice City. we got introduced to some of the characters, and I feel like next episode we might be introduced to a few more characters. So until then, that's when I'll see you.